Morning Restoration Church. Stand with us. It's time to bless the Lord. Did you come to worship Him today? Well, He is worthy of our praise, so put your hands together. We're going to sing His praise together. Here we go.
Let our praise be your welcome. Let our songs be a sign. We are here for you. We are here for you. Let your breath come from heaven.
Fill our hearts.
Fill our hearts with your light. We are here for you. We are here for you.
Oh, we bless you, Jesus, in this place. Ah.
To you our hearts are open. Nothing here is hidden. You are our one desire. You alone are holy. Only you are worthy, God. Let your fire fall down.
Send your fire in this place, Lord.
Let us shine. You're in now. Fill the skies. We are here for you. We are here for you.
Come on, sing it, church. Let your word.
Let your word move in power. Let what's dead come to life. We are here for you.
Yes, Lord.
We are here for you.
We open our hearts today.
To you our hearts are open. Nothing here is hidden. You are our one desire. You alone are holy. Only you are worthy, God. Let your fire.
Yeah.
Don't you love him today, church? Has he been good to you?
Amen. Yes. Thank you.
Oh, Jesus, we bless you in this place. We thank you that you are not still in the grave, but you are alive and well. know, if we're not careful, we'll relegate celebrating the resurrection to one Sunday a year. And how many of you know that he did not die and rise again so that you could have more abundant life one Sunday a year?
Come on.
How many of you know that he did not die and rise again so that you could have life more abundantly one day a week?
Come on.
He died, bore your sin, bore my sin, rose again in power on the third day, so that every day that we breathe breath on this earth, we can have life and have it more abundantly. I think we've got a reason to celebrate today. Somebody give praise to God. Hallelujah. He is risen. He is not dead. He is risen. God. Yes. Yes. And the fact that he has risen means that he holds all power in his hand. And he has got a plan for your life. Look at your neighbor and point at him and say, he's got a plan for your life. And I think we ought to celebrate that today. Ha! I know the plans I have for you. Anybody know what I'm talking about? I know just what you're going through.
Oh yeah.
So when you can't see what tomorrow holds and yesterday is through, remember I know the plans I have for you. Somebody hear the word of the Lord today. I know the plans I have for you. I know just what you're going through. So when you can't see what tomorrow holds and yesterday is through, remember I know. Somebody grab hold of it today. Sing it again. I know the plans I have for you. I know just what you're going through. So when you can't see what tomorrow holds and yesterday, remember I know the plans I have for you. And these are his plans for you. To give you hope for tomorrow, joy for your sorrow, strength for everything you go through. I know the plans I have for you. Come on, let's sing. I know the plans. I know the plans I have for you. Come on, sing it with confidence today. I know just what you're going through. So if you can't see what tomorrow holds and yesterday is through, remember I know. Tomorrow, joy for your sorrow, strength for everything you go through. you glad that God has a plan for you?
Amen.
Some of you are still not sure He does have a plan, so let's try that again. He really does have a plan, and it's a good plan. It's a plan for success and not for failure. It's a good plan. See, God will always have the final word in this world, and it will be good. It will be good. This week I was reading and doing some studying and stumbled across something that I've read, I don't know, probably hundreds of times, I'm sure. But how many of you know that the Word is still alive and active, and you can read the same thing over and over again, and suddenly something jumps out at you? Well, that's what I was doing. I was reading, and something just jumped out at me. I was reading in the book of Exodus. Anybody remember the story of Moses leading Israel out of Egyptian bondage? Anybody remember that?
Yes.
Seven of us. Gotcha. All right. Do you read your Bibles? It's right there in the Old Testament. Second book of the Bible, book of Exodus. Okay, it's right there. I was reading that account and suddenly saw something I'd never seen before. Because I've thought, and you've heard it, no doubt, that the whole point of the Exodus was getting these people out of slavery and get them into freedom, right? Do you know that that wasn't all the story? In fact, that wasn't even the main point of the story. The main point of the story is not to get people out of slavery. We've heard it used in that context all along, but that's not it. Because I was reading it, and suddenly it dawned on me as I was reading. Because here's what the Lord said to Moses. He said, Moses, I want you to go get my people out of Egypt so that they may serve me. The point is not to get them out of slavery into freedom. The point is to get them out of a place where they were inhibited from being able to serve the Lord the way that He had called them to, and get them over into God's presence where now they can be the people of God and fulfill their destiny that He's called them to.
That's right.
Crazy. Is that not fun? I mean, you've probably seen that, and you're looking at me like, what's the big deal, Pastor? I knew that, but I didn't know that. It was like, wow, there's something in there. For us to recognize that what God's got in mind for us is not just to get us out of sin's bondage, but to get us back over into the place where we can experience His presence in such a way that we can then fulfill the purpose to which He's called and designed us.
Amen, yes.